Today we will see the difference between source coding and channel coding. In the block diagram of the digital communication system, we know that first we have the information source, then the next block which we used was source encoder, which is used for source encoding. The next block was channel encoder, which was used for channel encoding, and then there was a modulator, which is used for the modulation, and then finally the modulated signal was transmitted through the channel to the receiver. At the receiver side, the decoding was done. So what is source coding? Source coding, as it is done by the source encoder, the basic phenomena of the basic concept behind source coding is that it removes the redundant bits, or you can say the redundant bits to be as extra bits. The extra bits or the redundant bits are removed in source coding. Thus, here we use variable length coding techniques. Variable length coding techniques like Huffman codes, Shannon Fanuc codes are used. These codes give codes which are of variable length, that different codes will be of different length, and the size of the code word will depend upon the probability of the occurrence of that symbol. Higher the probability of occurrence, lower will be the information content in that symbol. Why? Because information is given by log base 2 1 upon probability of xi. That means if the probability of occurrence of any symbol is less, then its information content will be more. Okay, let's suppose that we have a discrete memoryless source which is emitting different symbols, and the probability of occurrence of different symbols are different. So which symbol will have more information and which symbol will have less information, that will depend on the probability of occurrence of that symbol. Higher the probability of occurrence, remember that the information in that symbol will be lower. That means for symbols which have lower probability of occurrence, they will have higher information content. Just see the formula, IXI is equals to log to the base 2 1 upon PXI. So here, based on the probability criteria, the length of the code words are decided. That means additional bits or extra bits which are of no use are removed. Thus, the required bandwidth in source encoding is considerably reduced. That means the bandwidth requirement in this technique is less, because we are using here variable length codes, and the size of those codes or the information content in those codes, because higher the information content, higher the number of bits will be there in the code word, and lower the probability, higher will be the information content. That means higher will be the number of bits in that given code word. That is why when we studied Huffman code and Shannon Fanuc code, we saw that we were arranging the symbols in the decreasing order of the probability. But when we encoded the code word, we saw that as the probability was decreasing, the size of the code words were increasing, because for lower probability symbols the information content was more, and that is why the number of bits for that corresponding symbols were more. So source encoding is basically removing the redundant bits, which further reduces the bandwidth requirement of this scheme. Now let us come to channel encoding. Channel encoding is done by the next block, which is the channel encoder. In this channel encoder, additional bits, which are also called as parity bits, check bits or redundant bits, are added to the source code word. Source code word is the output of the source encoder, which becomes the input to the channel encoder. The channel encoder will add redundant bits to the source code word. Why these redundant bits are added? To give the capability of error correction to the codes, because when we introduce redundant bits, the probability of occurrence of errors is reduced. That is, for the increasing the capability of error detection and correction, redundant bits are added. Now when more bits will be added, required bandwidth will be also more. Thus this scheme will need more bandwidth, but the advantage is that we can control the error in this type of encoding scheme. That is why it is also known as forward error control coding. Bandwidth requirement is increasing, but at the same time we are able to detect and correct the errors. So we can make a trade-off here between the bandwidth and the error correction capability of the code. The error correcting codes are such as linear block codes, cyclic codes, convolutional codes. These codes are used to detect the errors and correct the errors in the received code words. So this is the basic difference between the source coding and channel coding. Source coding removes the redundant bits, thus reducing the bandwidth requirement. Channel encoding adds the additional bits, thus increasing the bandwidth requirement, but giving the capability of error detection and correction to the codes.